Hey all, welcome to ShareTrek. This is Raj here, friends. There's a little bit of good information that's available. It comes from NIH. I was scanning their pages, so I have information about a new peptide-based antibody which actually attaches to the fusion protein of HIV. So it's going to be targeting an area which is not mutating too often, because if it mutates, HIV can't survive. It's a conserved area. So it sounds exciting. So I've taken the script and I've given it to Notebook LLM. And as always, they have an entertaining podcast out here. Listen to that and let me have your comments. Let's get started.
Welcome back, everybody, to the Deep Dive. Ready for another Deep Dive today?
Always.
I am pumped for this one. We are talking HIV research.
Ooh, exciting.
I know, right? And specifically, we are looking at a study that was recently published in Science Translational Medicine. And
yeah, I saw that one.
I know you did. That's why you're here. So to kick things off, can you just give us like a quick rundown of what makes this study so unique?
Yeah, so this study is focusing on antibodies that can block HIV infection.
Whoa!
And they show that it works in monkeys.
What?
Which is a huge step toward a potential vaccine for humans.
So antibodies blocking HIV infection, that's like straight out of a sci-fi movie. Like, how does that even work?
It's pretty cool. Yeah. So HIV needs a specific key to get into and infect our cells.
Okay.
And these antibodies are basically jamming that keyhole.
Ah.
They target a part of the HIV virus called the fusion peptide.
Fusion peptide.
Which is essential for the virus to fuse with the cell membrane and get inside. And so by blocking the fusion peptide, the antibodies prevent the virus from getting a foothold.
So it's like they're stopping the virus before it can even start doing any damage.
Exactly.
That's amazing. And this wasn't just like a small-scale experiment, right? This was a pretty big deal.
No, this was a big deal. This research was conducted by the Vaccine Research Center at the National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Diseases.
Oh, wow.
Or NIAI, for short.
NIA.
Yeah, and they're kind of a leading authority in infectious disease research, so their findings carry a lot of weight.
Okay, so we're not just talking about some like fringe theory here.
Absolutely not.
This is like the real deal.
Real deal. Yeah, and the study was actually designed as a proof of concept.
Okay.
So it's designed to show whether this particular approach to an HIV vaccine could actually work.
So did it work?
Well, the results are really promising.
Okay.
So they tested these antibodies in rhesus macaques.
Rhesus macaques.
Rhesus macaques, yeah. So they have immune systems very similar to our own.
Oh, interesting.
So they're ideal for studying HIV. They expose the monkeys to SHIV, which stands for simian HIV. It's closely related to HIV. Oh, okay.
But it infects monkeys.
So they basically like simulated a real world HIV infection.
Exactly.
In these monkeys.
Yeah.
To see if the antibodies could hold up.
To see if they would work.
That's pretty intense.
It is. And what they found was remarkable. All the monkeys that received a placebo became infected with SHIV.
Okay.
But the groups that received the antibodies showed significant protection.
Okay, that's good news.
That's good news.
But what does significant protection actually mean? Like, did any of the monkeys avoid infection completely?
Yes. So in some of the groups that received the antibodies, there were zero infections.
Zero.
Zero.
Wow. That's amazing.
It's pretty amazing.
So they tested these antibodies in monkeys. Obviously, we can't test them in humans ethically, but how do we know that this is going to translate to humans?
That's a great question. And while we can't be absolutely certain until human trials are conducted,
right,
there's good reason for optimism.
Rhesus macaques are a very reliable model for HIV research. And the fact that these antibodies were so effective in preventing SHIV infection is a very positive sign.
So it's not a guarantee, but it's a pretty good indicator that this approach could work in humans.
Exactly.
Okay, so this is really cool. I'm very interested to see where this goes.
Me too.
So one other question. So they tested three different antibodies.
Yes.
A human antibody.
Right.
And two antibodies that they isolated from vaccinated monkeys.
That's right.
Wait, antibodies from vaccinated monkeys?
Yeah.
Does that mean they've already figured out how to make a vaccine?
Not quite, but it is a big step in that direction.
Okay.
So these monkey-derived antibodies show that it is possible to trigger the immune system to produce these specialized HIV-blocking antibodies.
That's amazing.
Now the challenge is figuring out how to do that reliably and safely in humans.
So it's like they found the secret ingredient, but they still need to kind of perfect the recipe.
Yeah, that's a great way to put it.
Okay, cool. So I guess kind of going off of that, they found that the protective effect of the antibodies was dose-dependent.
Yes.
Meaning that the higher the concentration of the antibodies in the monkey's blood, the better the protection.
Exactly.
So more antibodies equals more protection.
Basically, yeah.
Why is that so important?
Well, this information is crucial for vaccine development because it tells scientists exactly how more antibody a vaccine would need to produce to be effective in humans.
Okay.
It gives them like a target to aim for.
So they're not just like shooting in the dark here.
No, they've got a very specific goal in mind.
Which makes the whole process a lot more efficient.
A lot more efficient, yeah.
Okay, so that makes sense.
Yeah.
And I guess also they discovered that administering the antibodies 5 days before exposure to SHIV provided the best protection.
That's right.
So timing is key as well.
Yeah, you can't just give someone these antibodies right before they're exposed to HIV and expect them to work.
Right.
They need to be present in the body at a sufficient level before exposure to the virus occurs for this type of antibody to be effective.
So it's like having your defenses up.
Exactly.
Ready before the enemy even arrives.
Yes. Very good analogy.
Thanks.
Yeah. So this finding is important because it tells us that for this type of antibody to be effective, it needs to be present in the body at a certain level before exposure.
Got it. And that's a crucial piece of information.
Yes.
For designing preventative strategies using these antibodies, whether it's through a vaccine or some other delivery method.
Exactly.
This is awesome. I'm really liking this research.
Me too.
It's really exciting.
Yeah.
Okay, well, this has been a lot of great information so far, but I want to hear more about how this approach differs from past attempts.
Yeah, of course.
At developing an HIV vaccine.
Okay.
Okay, so we've been talking a lot about these antibodies.
Yeah.
And how promising they are in monkeys.
Yeah.
And how it could potentially work in humans. I'm kind of curious, though.
Sure.
What makes this approach different from, like, other past attempts at developing a vaccine for HIV? Have scientists tried using antibodies before?
Yeah, they have, but previous attempts just haven't been as successful.
Okay.
One of the biggest challenges with HIV is that it mutates like crazy.
Yeah.
It evolves so quickly, it makes it really difficult to create a vaccine that can actually keep up with all the different strains.
Okay.
But this approach is different because it targets the fusion peptide.
Right.
Which is a really specific part of the virus that doesn't change that much.
So it's like they found HIV's Achilles heel.
Exactly.
And that's why it's so effective. Because it's so essential for the virus's ability to infect cells.
Exact.
So blocking it is like the key.
Yeah, that's why these antibodies have been so successful.
This is really starting to feel like a game changer.
It is.
But HIV is a tough opponent.
Oh, yeah.
Are there any hurdles that could still, like, derail this research?
There are always challenges in research, especially when you're dealing with a virus as complex as HIV.
Right.
One potential issue is that while the fusion peptide is highly conserved, there's still some variation.
Okay. So even though it's like a weak spot?
Yeah.
It's not the same weak spot in every HIV strain.
Right. There are slightly different versions of this weak spot.
Okay.
It's possible that a vaccine based just on these antibodies might not be effective against every single strain.
I see. Yeah.
So that is something to consider.
So how do we get around that? How do we make sure that a future vaccine will provide protection against, like, all the different types of HIV?
Right. So the most likely scenario is that a vaccine will need to generate multiple types of these fusion peptide antibodies.
Okay.
Each one targeting a slightly different variant of the fusion peptide.
So it's like having an army of antibodies.
Yeah.
That are all trained to take down a specific type of HIV.
That's a great way to put it. It's like a multi-pronged attack.
That makes sense.
That would make it way harder for the virus to escape.
Right, because even if it gets past one,
exactly,
there's another one waiting right there.
Yeah. So, yeah, it sounds like a lot of work.
It does.
But I think the progress that they've made is remarkable.
Oh, absolutely. And this research goes beyond just HIV.
It does.
It's like paving the way for other antibody-based vaccines.
Yeah, exactly.
For other infectious diseases.
It is. It's really exciting.
So what other diseases do you think could benefit from this research?
Well, a lot of viruses use a fusion mechanism to enter cells.
Okay.
So the possibilities are kind of endless.
Wow.
You know, like influenza, measles, even some coronaviruses, like the one that causes COVID-19.
Really?
They all rely on fusion.
So this could have like major global health implications.
Yeah, it's huge.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Imagine a world where we have effective antibody-based vaccines.
Right.
or treatments for a huge range of viral diseases.
Yeah.
I mean, that's what this research is pointing towards.
That's the future.
That's the future.
That's awesome. So you mentioned earlier that they tested two antibodies isolated from vaccinated monkeys.
Yeah.
Can you talk more about what makes those antibodies special?
Yeah. So those antibodies are really interesting because they were produced by the monkeys' own immune systems in response to the vaccination.
Oh, wow.
That means that if we can figure out how to create a vaccine that triggers the same response in humans,
yeah,
we could potentially train our bodies to produce these awesome HIV-blocking antibodies on their own.
So it's like teaching our immune system how to fight HIV without having to rely on external antibodies.
Exactly.
That's amazing.
And that is the ultimate goal of any vaccine, to stimulate long-lasting immunity that can protect us from disease.
This is definitely giving me hope for a future where HIV is no longer a threat.
I agree.
That's awesome.
This research has opened up a whole new avenue for HIV vaccine development.
Yeah.
And it's given us super valuable insight
totally.
That could lead to breakthroughs in the fight against other diseases as well.
Absolutely. Okay, well, we've got to take a quick break.
Okay.
But when we come back, I want to touch on the broader implications of this research.
Sounds good.
So we've been talking all about this amazing HIV research. And how cool is it that it could, like, change the game for other viruses, too?
Yeah, it really could.
It's pretty awesome to think that we could be on the cusp of a whole new era of, like, fighting infectious diseases.
Yeah, it really is a huge paradigm shift.
Yeah.
You know, for decades, the focus has been on treating infections after they happen.
Right.
But now we're talking about, like, preventing them in the first place.
Right, with these antibodies.
Yeah, these targeted antibodies.
Yeah, and not even just preventing them, but, like, training our bodies to become these like virus fighting machines.
Yeah, it's really cool.
So we've talked a lot about the science, but what does all this mean for people who are living with or at risk of HIV? What does this research mean for their future?
That's the most important part, right? I mean, for people living with HIV, the hope is that this research could lead to new treatment options.
Okay.
So imagine therapies that provide longer lasting protection.
Okay.
So you need fewer medications and fewer side effects.
That would be huge.
Yeah. It would be life-changing for so many people.
And what about prevention? Could this research finally lead to like a vaccine for HIV?
It's definitely a possibility.
Yeah.
This research has identified a really promising target for a vaccine. And the fact that they've been able to isolate these antibodies from vaccinated monkeys suggests that a vaccine is within reach.
It's amazing to think that we could be close to a world where HIV is no longer a threat.
Yeah. I mean, even if a vaccine takes some time, the potential for new treatments based on these antibodies is super exciting.
Totally. And it's not just about HIV.
Right.
This research is like a beacon of hope for other infectious diseases as well.
It is.
It could be used to develop similar therapies.
Right.
For the flu, measles, even coronaviruses.
It's amazing. It's like a domino effect of scientific progress.
Yeah.
With each breakthrough paving the way for the next.
It makes you realize how important this kind of research is and why it's so important to keep investing in these efforts.
I completely agree. Supporting scientific research is an investment in our future.
Yeah.
A future where we can all live healthier, longer lives.
Totally.
And not be afraid of infectious diseases.
Well, this has been an awesome deep dive.
Yeah, it
has. We've covered some really groundbreaking research.
Wow.
Explored the potential impact on HIV.
Yeah.
And even like glimpsed into a future where these diseases might be a thing of the past.
Hopefully.
It's a lot to think about.
It is.
But I hope it's been as fascinating for you as it has been for me.
It really has. It's been great being here.
And to our listeners, we hope this deep dive has sparked your curiosity.
Yeah.
We encourage you to kind of learn more about this research.
Keep learning.
And explore the world of infectious disease prevention.
Absolutely.
And just keep asking questions because as we learn today,
that's how we learn.
Even the toughest challenges can be overcome.
That's right.
With ingenuity, perseverance, and science.
For sure.
So stay curious, and until next time, keep on diving deep.
Bye, everyone.